Kaleidoscope, a public affairs presentation of KOCO-TV with hostess Carol Wilkinson.
Good morning. Wishing each one of you a very happy Easter. I hope your day is going beautifully. Excellence in education is one of the priorities for our whole state, and we're so proud this morning to have two special professors with us who are going to be talking about an honor that they won last year at the OU Faculty Tribute Luncheon. And this year we're going to talk about that luncheon, which is this next Thursday, April the 7th, with one of the committee members, Karen Luke. And I'd like for you to meet Dr. Stewart Ryan and Dr. Tom Miller, and we'll be talking with both of you in just a moment. Glad to have you on Kaleidoscope. Karen, the luncheon itself, I know that, for many years there have been tributes to our fine faculty at OU. However, we're really wanting more people to share that special tribute in the luncheon, and I think that's happening. Tell us a little bit more about that special occasion.
Well, it really is a day of just celebrating excellence, Carol, as you mentioned. And last year, the Board of Regents, particularly led by Sarah Hogan in this effort, Dr. Horton and the OU Foundation inaugurated this luncheon to recognize the commitment of the faculty and to give them some recognition and tribute for their commitment to educating students and to recognize them for their national achievements in scholarship and research.
You know, and I think the word commitment is very appropriate. I think in order to be a teacher, one really must be committed. And so I'm particularly proud to have both of you gentlemen with us this morning. Tom, first, a question. Since you are one of last year's recipients of a very special award, in physics, what do you feel is most important from your standpoint about teaching, and why did you decide that this is something you wanted to stay with?
Well, in teaching the physics majors is no problem. They're very dedicated and they're motivated and so forth. Teaching the non-science students or the students who don't have to be in the class is tricky. And I think that's where Stu and I come in, is keeping them interested.
So motivation plays an important part.
Oh, definitely.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, Stewart, from your standpoint, I know that you have to be terribly committed to your profession. And physics, though a serious, serious subject for most, you believe can be fun.
Oh, yes, it's definitely fun. I mean, that's why I became a physicist, why I teach. I really enjoy it so much. I'd really like other people to enjoy it. And it's really sort of a thrill to be able to show other people how much fun it can be.
Now, in your classrooms, I know that a lot of physics has to be serious, but I think that this morning you're going to demonstrate for us that it doesn't all have to be serious. And I just frankly wish that when I had been in college, I had had a professor such as doctors like you. It really would have been very special.
Well, thank you. It's a lot of fun.
Now, you have an alter ego that you might want to tell our audience about.
Well, it's always a little embarrassing to tell people my alter ego is, but maybe it's best if I show you.
Yes.
I'm Dr. Indestructo.
Okay? I would guess it in a moment.
That's right. And Dr. Indestructo is sort of a individual who does outrageous and dumb things in front of class and in front of kids, and so it's my way of teaching physics, I guess.
Well, would you and Tom show us some of the special things that help us learn?
Okay, Tom, I have here for you a balloon, and I've got one for myself here, and I thought it might be sort of fun to show you what happens when this balloon is filled with a light gas, and what I want to do is breathe this in and then tell you about it. Okay?
All right, yes.
I have to blow all the air out first.
When I do this, my voice sounds like Donald Duck because the speed of sound is higher in helium than it is in air, and so it raises...
But it does even more to my voice because my voice is higher than Stu's voice. And the speed of sound is greater, and so the resonant cavity is worse. But as it comes out, my voice gradually returns to normal.
My voice begins returning to normal, too. So helium-filled balloons are part of physics, and they're fun.
Okay. And you'd have our undivided attention.
Well, my students do enjoy seeing me make a fool out of myself, and I do a good job of that.
All right, gentlemen, what is our next example?
Okay, well, I thought what we might what we might try next is I brought something very, very cold today. It's air, which has been cooled so much it's turned from a gas into a liquid.
Yes.
And so that is air. That's the air that you breathe.
Yes.
And that's minus 196 degrees centigrade, minus 320. You can just hold that for a minute, because
right.
What I want to do first, I have a little bit of a slingshot here. Okay, a nice rubber hose, and I
right.
thought I'd show you what happens when you freeze it. Now that's warm, and it's boiling off some of that liquid. And as soon as it stops spitting out there, it's cold and nice
wow.
and hard like that.
Yes.
A lot of fun things you can do with liquid air. And so now I'll take here. Would you like that one?
Sure.
And you can hand me the other carnation now. And we thought we'd show you what happens when you take a pretty flower like this and you freeze it.
Oh, my.
Now, okay. I hope you don't mind if we use your carnation.
Certainly don't.
But anyhow, this carnation now, this is an old Jadar, right?
Yes. Shattered.
It's just shattering.
The crew will be delighted with me. delighted.
Yes. Then I thought what we might do, this is really very cold, and you saw that rubber hose was quite hard, but I thought what we might do is drink some of this for you.
Ah, a little cocktail.
A little cocktail, right. And do you want to stand up for this?
No.
Okay.
Well, down the hatch.
Down the hatch. actually, what I'm going to do is spit it back out. I'm
all
not
right.
going to swallow it, but here we go. excuse me, I froze my forehead.
Gentlemen, I can easily see why you have a rapt audience for your classes, and I know now why physics can, in fact, be fun. Karen, quickly, because we're running out of time, the tribute also has a monetary amount associated with it. What are some of the monetary amounts that these outstanding professors win?
Well, the George Lynn Cross Professor Award carries with it a $5,000 award. There's a Burlington Northern Fellowship. It is $5,000. The award that you won, I think, $2,000.
Wonderful.
It doesn't begin to repay the talent that we've
Absolutely
seen here,
not.
But it certainly is a nice way of saying thank you.
Well, thank you both again
for
being with
you,
us this morning. I'd love to have been in your class. Maybe I should think about that now.
I'd
love to. And Karen, thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Well, I appreciate it very much. Now, when we return from a commercial break, we're going to talk about this very special sculpture on our set and the Variety Clubs Golf Tournament. Stay tuned.